there, my stamping friends. It's Jackie Bolhuis from Klompen Stampers. Today, we are going to make a simple pocket card. Now, be honest with me. Raise your hand. I can see you. How many of you have a lot of designer series paper sitting around that you might not use or you're not using it? Well, this project is all about using up some of that paper on an easy, you could call it a fun fold. It's really a pocket card. And use it up and pop it in the mail to you. We're even gonna make our envelope look cute. Now this project was shared with me by one of my team members. I always have to stop and think, it's I, Missouric, shared this card with me. She sent it to me in the mail and I was so excited to get it. I love getting happy mail just like I love sending it. And I thought it was such a neat, easy idea that I really wanted to share it with you. So I asked her and she said, absolutely. So this is not my original idea. It came from one of my team members, but I'm so excited to share it. The great thing is, it's a great way to use up that designer series paper. So we're gonna make one, but then I have, I don't know, three or four different ones I've made using up some scraps of my designer series paper. And I can't wait to pop these in the mail to special people. So, without further ado, let's go ahead, flip this camera down, and let's make this quick and easy pocket card. Hang on. Now we're going to do some scoring and some cutting, but don't worry about remembering all these measurements. I will have a blog post, and you'll find the link to it down in the description of the video, that will show pictures of all the projects I have to share with you, but I'll also have a diagram for you that will show you exactly how to cut and score. After you watch this video, you're gonna see how easy it is, so you can go over there, grab that diagram, and I'm sure you're gonna love making these cards as well. So, like I said, any designer series paper will work. Great way to use up some of that that maybe you're not using. We have a 6 by 12 inch piece. So it's just a half sheet of 12 by 12. And we are gonna start out here by cutting this down to 9. So our piece that we're using is actually 6 by 9, but we're gonna use this for something else. So let's set that aside. So now we're 9 and 6. And we are gonna start out by scoring at 4 1/4. Let's make sure we have the scoring blade here, not the cutting one. And then we're gonna move it out here to 8 1/2. Oop, almost got the wrong blade. Keep that one up there. Okay, and then that leaves a 1/2 inch piece down at this side. You can't really see it. I thought you could see it on the other side, but not really. Okay, so we are scored at 4 1/2 and then 8 1/2. And then I'm going to just go ahead and turn it this way and score another 1/2 inch along the bottom. So we could measure out to 1/2 inch or we can measure out to 5 1/2. It's gonna give us the same thing. So let's do that. And oh, we're not gonna put that away yet. Now I wanna show you so that this makes sense. This is my whole 9 by 6. So I scored at 4 1/2 and then at 8 1/2. So that left me a 1/2 inch strip there. And then I turned it and we did a 1/2 inch along that bottom. Now the next thing we're going to do is we need to cut out wherever I have it colored in. So if we follow the pattern, we're gonna go on this 1/2 inch piece here, right up to that score line. Now you certainly could use a scissors. We'll see if I can see it here. Sometimes I use a scissors, sometimes I use my cutter. These score lines, this paper is really hard to see. So I'm kind of feeling it to see if we get to the score line. I think we're close. I like to do that one with my cutter just so it's nice and straight. And let's see, if I fold that, we'll see, oh, we're out a little bit. There's our score line, okay? And then for this other piece, we're gonna do it at just a little bit of an angle. Okay, actually, if I fold this, you'll see what I'm doing. You'll see how I just, I guess mitering, is that what they call that? So then if I, you know, I'm gonna fold both of these and you can see it a little bit better. That was that other score line there. And so we need to get rid of the little square that is down at this end, like so. And then we also wanna miter these a little bit. So we're just kinda starting out and going right up to that point. It'll make everything just fold up easier for you. So there you go. So if you look at our pattern here, you'll see, well, we'll flip it this way. This has been cut out, and then we have this flap, and we have that flap. Now let's put this together. So set this aside. Let's just fold all of these, and you'll see. What this is going to do is these are going to fold in like so and close like that to make our pocket. Now before I adhere these, what I wanna do is take my circle die And I am going to go ahead and cut a circle. It's gonna be like a little window in our pocket card. And I'm just gonna eyeball it left to right on that panel. And just make sure that you are up enough so that when this half inch flap folds in there, you don't see that. So it just needs to be up a little bit more than a half inch. So let me go cut that and I'll be right back. There we go. So this we can use on another project. We're not going to use that for this. And now we can go ahead and put our pocket card the pocket part of our card, and then we'll make the card to insert into it. So again, you can see what we've done here. Now you can use any type of adhesive for this, but I really found that the tear and tape works the best. And the little trick here is you need to make sure that this bottom folds up first, and then this right-hand side or left-hand side, depending on what side you cut it on, needs to come over it, okay? So bottom's gonna go up first. And what I'm going to do is take my tear and tape, and if you forget which way goes first, you know what'll happen? Because you'll do what I did. You'll stick it together and then it won't open correctly. So been there, done that. Let's see, we don't want that one. We want a little pokey end here. So what I'm going to do is I put that tear tape on there and I'm gonna tear it off. And oops, got a little bit left there. Get that all so we get nice and good sticky stuff there. And then because I mitered this, there's not a whole lot holding these two pieces together, but that holds it enough to at least keep it there a little bit. And then we'll take some tear and tape and we'll come on this side. So what happens if you do this in the wrong order, you won't have that full pocket there. So it will make a difference and the little card we make to go in there won't work. Okay, then this tape is not, I think I just spun that in a whole circle, didn't I? It's not forgiving at all. So when you close this, you want to be very careful that you're just lining those edges up along the side and stick it together. So there is our pocket. Now, one thing before we set this aside and start stamping our card, you want to make a little notch in it. So you can use either a circle die up at the top, you know, just half of it or so. It doesn't matter exactly what size, or a circle punch if you have one of those. And since I'm here, we'll use that one. Okay, pocket is complete. So we have a piece of basic white, 3¾ by 5, I believe that is. And then 4 by 5¼ is our just jade layer. So I don't want to glue these together yet. I never glue anything until after I have stamped it because, you know, you can always flip it over if you stamp it wrong. But if we glue it down, then we can't use the other side. And then I'm going to carefully stick this in here. And notice that I'm holding those pieces together so they stay, you know, approximately where they're going to layer. And now we can see where we want to do our stamping. So let's get our pads out here. We have Calypso Coral and Just Jade and Misty Moonlight. I am using a stamp set called In Symmetry, which is the stamp set that goes with this beautiful paper. So I love how these all work together. And then we're gonna start with our leaves. And I want to make sure I just stamp, you know, far enough down so everything is going to fit in my circle. Now you do have to be a little careful with your stamps so that you don't, you know, get ink. Well, I do get ink on it, but we want to make sure it doesn't touch that designer series paper. So I held it down there. And then let's go ahead and let's see, what other one do I have here? Thanks, friend. So all of these stamps are part of this In Symmetry. Ooh, do we got room? Just barely. There we go. Thanks so much. So now we can pull it out. I like how it's stamped, so we can go ahead and we'll take our adhesive and we'll stick that on there and we'll go ahead and put on. Remember, any stamps, any inks, any paper, this is just doesn't take a lot of product at all. And you'll see now how that just slides in like so. Now, if you want to, you could put a little pull tab on that. So let's just go ahead and do that. I love this little gingham ribbon here. So let's cut a piece of this. Let's see, we'll just put two little snips on there. And you could use adhesive on this, but what I found works really good for this is my stapler. So we're gonna go ahead and just kind of separate those a little bit. And then we can grab the stapler, put it about in the middle there. And we'll staple that down. Look at how cute. Now, if you want them a little bit shorter, I like to start out long and then I trim them afterwards. There we go. And we'll stick it in. So there is our card. Now, this is the exact size of a normal card, okay? 5.5 by 4.25. So that means I can stick it into a normal envelope, which, oops, that's not the one I want. Let's see, I got some over here. There is our envelope. And what I'm gonna do, remember this little piece we cut off? Because we started at 12 inches, we only needed 9. Well, we are going to use that on our envelope flap, because this whole pocket card, we can stick in the envelope. Let's see what, ooh, that's a tough decision. I think I'm gonna use this side of it, because then it kind of coordinates more with our stamping. And that's gonna look really nice with that blue pocket in there. So I stick it down, and then this, when I do this, I don't measure this piece. It doesn't really matter as long as it's big enough to cover the envelope, which I knew cutting 3 inches off was perfect. So there's that. And now we can, I just kind of bend that down a little bit, and that will stick so nicely. There we go. Right into our envelope. Now, if you want to, you could do, you know, you could stamp on the front too. Should we do that? Because let's see, can we do it when it's in there? I always like to make my envelope super pretty. So we have designer series paper, and then we can even add one of these same flowers, because this card was so easy with limited stamping. So we might as well do some more right there. Hey friend, now Liz, look at how cute that is. Wouldn't that be fun to go out to your mailbox and find something like that? So there is our simple pocket card. Now let me show you a couple other ones that I've made. Here is our Harvest Meadow stamp set and designer series paper. You can see I just used the same side of the paper. And pull it out, and it just says a happy hello to you. Now I used a whole bunch of different products on these different paper stamps and greetings and so forth. I'll have pictures of these along with everything I used over on that blog post as well, so you can figure that out. Now notice with this one, I did not put the little pull tab, but a person when they receive it knows it comes out because of our little notch there. So you can do the pull tab or not do the pull tab. Then here is my little Christmas version. Look at that. May this be a Christmas to remember and cherish. So if you still need to whip out a few Christmas cards, you could do that. Now this one would also be fun for a gift card. What I would do is on the back side, make a little pocket, or actually you could just put your gift card in there. And then when you put this in, just make sure that the gift card's behind it here. And that way you don't know there's a gift card in there. You pull it out and you would see it right there. So again, if you got a lot of designer series paper sitting around that's Christmas that you're not gonna use, there's a great idea for you. Let's see, I have a couple more here. This is new paper, Eden's Garden, that is available. It's on like kind of a pre-purchase with the stamp set, but the paper's only available while supplies last. And when I recorded this video, it was still available. So hopefully it is. It is stunningly beautiful paper. And what I did, I stamped with Forever Fern. So I did not use the coordinating stamp set because I thought the fern looked great with it. But if you like this paper, make sure to grab that, because that will not be available. The stamps will, but the paper will not be available come January. So there is that one. And let's see, here was the one we made. And then I want to just share with you, this is the one that my team member, I Mazurek, made for me and sent to me. So this is some retired product. But look at how cute that was. She didn't put the tab on it, but that's where I saw this super cute, easy idea that I thought was so fun. And when she mailed it to me, it was in an envelope as well. So I hope you like this quick and easy pocket card today. Great way to use up some of those scraps, and it does not require very many supplies. So I hope you give this idea a try. Remember to hop over to my blog post. I'll have pictures, supply lists, and I'll also have a cutting and scoring diagram to make it super easy for you to create this. I hope you enjoyed today's project. I'll be stamping with you again real soon. Have a stamp happy day.